My vision is to use technology and leverage the opportunity of technology with people to improve people's lives. I see technology as a tool, as an accelerator, and how we use technology to develop new scenarios to improve how we live in this planet. This is our vision. And in the Mobile World Capital Foundation, what we try to leverage is basically the balance in how the use of technology generates new experiences, new scenarios, basically to improve security, to improve privacy, and to have new and more rich user experiences with the use of the technology. Well, when we look to the Gartner Group mega trends, basically we see four big changes in our environment because of the four mega trends of technology. Artificial intelligence and big data are clear, one of the major pillars. The cloud and the transformation on the cloud services, how we democratize services that in the past were only for large corporations and now reach small, medium-sized enterprises. Social networks, and the fourth is the mobility. And probably the mobility has been the largest and with the bigger impact that has transforming our lives. No? These are the four mega trends. And these four mega trends are going faster than expected. And we see now a moment where the humanism, ethical and social impact are becoming a key pillar in how we use technology for the future. And regarding these four mega trends, 5G in the next 2 to 8 years will transform dramatically the way we operate, the way we communicate, the way we use transportation and mobility. And we see new internet services of the future leveraging the opportunity of this new generation of telecommunication services. Well, how we see that 5G will change our lives? What will change in our environment? We see basically four major impacts that are coming with the 5G, with the new generation of telecommunication services. The first is ultra high definition and fast speed on data management. We are talking about 100 times faster than the communication that we have today. So looking to the future, we will be able to look to holograms, for example, with a higher definition that will be very difficult for our eyes to see if there are physical objects, real objects, or are really digital images. The precision will be extremely high. Secondly, we talk about real time on the network, or that the technicians talk about latency. So we will have fast response time of any communication on the network. So we will reduce the 20 to 30 milliseconds to less than 1 millisecond. This will open a new world where drones, robots, self-driven cars will be safe because the response time on the network will be instant. This will open new scenarios on the use of the 5G. The third is the reduction of and the savings of energy. We will see reductions of the savings of energy for more than 90%. So we will have sensors that will be autonomous, that will not require electricity or power, and will be alive for 8 or 9 years. So we'll be able to deploy sensors in our houses, in the cities, in our factories, and this will provide us new data and new information that will help us to customize new services. And the fourth big change that is coming with 5G is that 5G is the first telecommunication network that is not just a transport telecommunication network to transport in the voice or data. We'll have services. We'll have capability of computer power and also saving storage of data. So they will include new services on top of what is basically a communication and transportation network. Big changes that will open new world on internet services with ultra high definition that will change the environment of entertainment and with real time response time that will change, for example, mobility, how we will manage with connected cars and connected devices in our cities will change dramatically the way we manage mobility in our lives. We will see with 5G new rich entertainment experiences with ultra high definition. So this will open a new world where virtual reality and augmented reality applications will be deployed massively. In entertainment, for example, we have seen in this edition of the Mobile World Congress the first 5G football stadium that with the football club Barcelona, and we see a part of a match and a coach session on real time in 3D, in 360 dimension, in a very immersive experience where we feel like if we were in the playing with Messi and Suarez on the Nou Camp. So this was very inspirational about how we see in the future new rich entertainment and how the industry of content and entertainment will change thanks to the 5G. Well, the digital transformation are opening new doors of new business model. From the foundation, we have been working in the last 5 years, developing the 4 years from now as a vehicle, as an event where entrepreneurs show new business models that digitalization is opening. And we follow with high interest the progress of JET8, rewarding talent that is providing content to the community and generating new opportunities to share knowledge and share content. So I think that this will change in the industry. As we have seen in 4 years from now, a lot of new business models that have changed in finance, in insurance, in healthcare. So in the industry of content management and knowledge management, I see that the digitalization is opening doors for new business models, and we see that the experience and the initiative of JET8 is very interesting to follow. We see from the transformation of mobility services that blockchain is a driver of generating a high level of interest regarding security. So we follow with high interest associations as Alastria, where corporations, banks, utilities companies, software houses, the open source community are working together to share technology and best practices in order to improve security in any transaction to give much more trust to our citizens in the future. Well, we see at this moment that is crucial to reach an agreement, as we have done with the climate change, on how we'll use in the future the technology, where the focus should be a much more humanistic approach with social impact, and we need to look to minimize the risk of bad use of the technology, looking to improve security on data management and transactions, to give trust to our citizens around the digital transactions, to improve and reach agreements regarding ethics on artificial intelligence and algorithms that are critical and are changing a lot of process, and to ensure that the new disruptions and the speed of the disruption avoids to leave people behind and leave people that have not access to some of this transformation. So for us, I think that is the right time to reach agreements between corporations, governments and multinational entities, as we have done with the climate change, putting the humans on the center, putting the person on the center, and ensuring that the future of our society embrace disruption of technology in a positive way to improve people's lives.